Operant conditioning is all about how consequences shape behaviors. Every consequence you experience can be sorted into one of four types. To master these concepts, it helps to pull them apart. First, let's break down reinforcement and punishment. If a consequence strengthens or increases a behavior, that's reinforcement. If it weakens or decreases the behavior, that's punishment. Next, let's differentiate between positive and negative, the part that often trips people up. Ironically, you've probably been conditioned to think positive means good and negative means bad. But here, it's not about good or bad at all. Instead, positive simply means you're adding or increasing something, and negative means you're removing or reducing something. Here's your mental checklist. First ask, in the consequence, was something added, positive, or removed, negative? Then ask, was the behavior strengthened, reinforcement, or weakened, punishment? Now let's put these parts back together. Positive reinforcement, something is added and this strengthens the behavior. Negative reinforcement, something is removed and it strengthens the behavior. Positive punishment, something is added and this weakens the behavior. And negative punishment, something is removed and it weakens the behavior. Now let's apply these concepts to four examples. In one of B.F. Skinner's famous pigeon experiments, the birds learned to peck a lever. Every time they pecked, they got a food pellet, which led to more lever pecking. Let's break this down. The pigeon pecked the lever, behavior, and it got a food pellet, consequence. Now, focusing in on the consequence, was something added or removed? Something was added, so it's positive. Next, did it increase or decrease the behavior? Increase, so it's a reinforcement. This is an example of positive reinforcement. Example number two, you're speeding and you get a $100 ticket. In the consequence, was something added or removed? The ticket was added, so it's positive. Is the behavior, speeding, strengthened or weakened? Weakened, so it's punishment. This is an example of positive punishment. And again, it isn't positive because it's good. In operant conditioning, positive simply means that something was added or increased. Next, you forget to do your chores, so your parents take away your phone for the night. Again, focusing in on the consequence, was something added or removed? The phone was taken away, so it's negative. And does this strengthen or weaken the behavior? It's meant to weaken skipping chores, so it's a punishment. This is negative punishment. For our last example, let's say you take an aspirin and your headache goes away. In the consequence, was something added or removed? Your headache was removed, so it's negative. Is the behavior strengthened or weakened? Well, you'll want to use aspirin again the next time your head hurts, so strengthened. It's a reinforcement. This is an example of negative reinforcement. And again, it isn't negative because it's bad. Negative here simply means that something was removed. So, to correctly label a consequence, simply ask, is something added or removed? And did the behavior increase or decrease? That's all you need to crack the code on the four types of operant conditioning. Now go reinforce your own learning, maybe with a food pellet or a cookie.